NoLoco is a powerful tool that will allow you to build your own custom applications and deploy them to end users. And you can do it all without knowing how to write a single line of code. In this video, I want to show you how you can leverage the power of workflows inside of NoLoco. This is akin to automation. It allows you to have things perform magically in the background based on rules and conditions that you establish up front. So we're going to be taking a look at how you can leverage workflows in NoLoco. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and NoLoco is one of our favorite front-end application builders. Beyond that, we can even put our data structure, the data schema itself, in NoLoco, or we could have it in a third-party tool like an Airtable or a Smart Suite, you name it. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be breaking down the workflow capabilities inside of NoLoco. But before we get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to join me for automation training. This training is tool agnostic. It doesn't matter what system you're using to build your automation magic, right? You can do it in no code in a number of different places. And I'm going to teach you the basics of automation in that training. So go ahead and sign up at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Now let's hop on into the heart of things and get into our video here. I'm going to jump into my screen and I'm already in my NoLoco. You can see I'm building an app from scratch using the AI assistant, and I'm going to be using NoLoco's back end. So I already wrote this all out for us, but you can see that we're building a project management system with the following sets of, I put date, but I need it to be data. It's going to be projects, tasks, and users. These are the three different tables I want to create here. And presumably, NoLoco's AI will help us build it in the background. So once I hit build my app, it's going to do this. But the key takeaway I want to emphasize for you is that we want our application to say, all right, a project can be one of several different types of project. And depending on the type of project and who it's assigned to, who is the project manager and who are the two assistants, see here in my text output here, depending on what we've picked here, then the tasks are going to be generated automatically. And that's what we need to build in our workflows. So now that we've put this all out here, we can say, let's go ahead, let's get this thing going. And while we wait for NoLoco, it's going to be doing the thinking. We will see how quickly this comes together. Pretty fast, right? So here's what we have so far. It's saying, hey, we think this is what you're going to need to start. Projects. And you can see here that we've got the project name, the project type. This is perfect. The type of data it's using here is a dropdown. So it's going to give us different options to select. And of course, we have a link to the project manager and two links to assistants. This is exactly what we asked for. Links from our projects table to our tasks table. And then here's one example from the collection. So of the link to tasks. And so here we have all of that. And then here on our tasks table, it's giving us a breakdown. Well, look, it's going to be linked to a project, obviously. We've got the task itself. What user is it assigned to? So it's a linked relationship here. This is exactly what we would expect from this backend. Now you'll note that it has not highlighted users, because users, that third table, is in every single application that we build. When we build an application, it's deployed to users. So obviously, here we go. Now, if we want to further visualize this before we actually build the app, we can click to visualize, and it actually shows us a different, you know, schema. This is more akin to what you might expect in an actual application schema when you're looking at the different tables that you've built and how they're interrelated, et cetera. Now, long story short, we're happy with this. So let's say next, and it's just going to build our app for us. Now, I want to highlight for you, of course, this is fully customizable. So if you don't love this, if you want to change the way this stuff comes about, that's perfectly fine. You can obviously make all the changes your heart desires in the back end when you're working with NoLoco. Now let's cut on into the actual application itself. This has been magically built for us, again, using the AI and just kind of going through the steps. But we get to the point where we want to look at our actual data on the back end. So on the left-hand side, we can go in and look at the three different tables. And as I said, user is going to be created every time. And now we have projects and tasks as well, which is perfect. And of course, we have the linked relationships that we were discussing as we were looking this over. So the different projects have the project type. And of course, we can also store information about the different tasks, etc. Now, let's set up some example data, right? So we can create our first project, and we'll just call it project one. And maybe we have a bunch of different types of projects to select from. We have type one, two, and three as examples, but we can always, you know, name this differently. But ideally, what we want is to say, okay, when a project has been created and, more importantly, assigned to users, so we have a project manager and we've assigned two assistants to it, at that time, we want to create tasks. How would we do this? Well, this is where workflows come into play. On the left-hand side here, come down to the electrical symbol, the little lightning bolt, and we can select workflows. And here we can actually create a workflow. So we'll do this and we'll say, well, it's going to originate from the project. So let's select that. And it's going to say, you know, by default, we're selecting a trigger here when a project is created. But we can update this, right? Maybe we don't want this to trigger on the creation of the project. In our case, we want to wait until a project has been assigned to people and has a specific type assigned. And maybe the tasks that we create are different based on what type of project it is. So let's assume if it's type one, we're going to create three tasks. Well, then we might build a workflow for that specific use case. You can see here that we have four different options. When a project is created, when a project is updated, when a project is deleted, or on demand. So we can do it by triggering from a button. I really like using buttons inside of our applications because we can ensure that people put in the information that we need and then they can push that button. So let's go with this choice. We can say when a button is pressed, and we could add this button to any page inside of our application once we actually deploy it. But presumably it would be inside of a project, right? We would say, hey, you can create a new project, probably through a form. We would make certain fields required. That is to say, you have to assign it to people. You have to choose the type of project. And then once that project is then created, there's a page where you can click that button. So let's go ahead and add those actions. We can say, well, in this particular case, we want to what? We want to create new records. And we could set up multiple action steps where we create new records inside of our application in our tasks table. Now, alternatively, note that there's a lot more we can do with it than just creating new things. We have a lot of different options. We can send email from our actual application itself. We can send a push notification, which is great, especially if you have PWA enabled, progressive web apps. People will get notifications right then and there on their mobile device. We can also trigger a webhook, send something to Zapier or Make. We can also, again, create records, update records, delete records, only continue under certain filters. So in our particular case, we only want to create these different tasks if it is project type one, right? So we could apply a filter right here and say, well, look, we only want to do this if the trigger project, that is the project type that triggered this automation, is exactly or is equal to, and then we can enter in a value from this, right? So what are the values that this could possibly be? Well, we chose like type one, so we could put that in here. We could also say it's not a dynamic value. So right here, we can come in and say, I only want to continue and create these tasks if it is project type one. And this is just the basics of automation, right? All of these workflows are held directly inside of our application. And this is fantastic. It does not require us to go outside to a third-party tool like a Zapier or a Make. Of course, we can do that if we need to take things up a notch, but it's so much easier to manage your system internally in as few software as possible. I always encourage this. You know, don't use extra tools if you don't need to. Only if you need that more advanced functionality does it make sense to go out and get third-party automation tools, third-party database, et cetera. So here we are. We've got our condition that we built, and then we can add additional actions. Let's just take an example of creating one task. So I could say create a record here as my action. Where do I want to create this? Of course, I choose the table, and here it's called tasks. And I can set up what I'm going to collect. So, you know, right here, I could establish comments. Of course, we don't have very many fields in that particular table yet, so I need to build those out. But ultimately, I would want to link it to, of course, the project that we just created. The task needs to be connected to the actual project and properly assigned either to the project manager or to the other assistants that are on that project. So hopefully this allows you to start to see all of the possibilities that are available here. You know, these things will happen inside of your application right in the NoLoco system itself. Meaning, again, we don't have to go outside to third-party tools. Strongly recommend implementing workflows wherever possible inside of your no-code applications. If you can do it natively in the software like you can here, of course, that is my first choice every time. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, so if there are things we did not quite answer, feel free to swing by our website and poke around and find the answers you're looking for. And of course, if you got value from this, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and give us a thumbs up. But most importantly, keep on building.